bosom says aloha to his sweetheart Hawaii. The drowsy islands slumbered one by one, close their sleepy eyes, say goodnight to the sun.
Hey. Hi. Hold on. No. Didn't know you were there. How you guys doing? Aloha. Mahalo.
I think Mahalo's thinking.
Shave ice. How's everybody doing? It's been a while since we got together. Salud. Cheers. Sláinte. Mahalo. I missed you. Stop laughing, Annie. Cheers, everybody. I'm going to stop talking and get to the music because I think that's why we're all here. Oh, man. So red. You guys good? Everybody okay? It's been a while. It's been a year exactly to the weekend. More on that later. But, salud, let's have an enchanting evening together, shall we? Okay. Let's see if we can do this right. You just can't find the words when you're waiting for an answer that you've already heard. When you're drowning in the moment, but you never learn to swim as the distance grows between your shores. You know how this one ends. Thank you.
It's been a while since I've done this, and I forgot about the whole can't really tell if people are there thing.
Well, you also forgot the shot of tequila before you started.
I did. I did. It makes me think of that Sammy Hagar song, Mas Tequila, the Red Rocker. How'd that guy get that gig? Anyway, cheers, everybody. 1 year ago, yesterday, I flew home from LA and came home. And here we are a year later. And you would think that you guys watching this show, if you don't know me by now, you're still making these really terrible requests. I mean, not terrible. I mean...
Now I can't tell if people are fucking with us.
Yeah.
But like, I don't know.
There's a couple good friends that are like, do this. I'm like, what's the motivation? Yeah. You will never, never know me. All right, well, let's move on. Everybody good?
Yeah. Woohoo! We got a woohoo!
We got a woohoo.
We're here.
You will never, never know me.
Play Nemo, please.
Play Nemo? Oh man,
you got a heart in a blender, so.
You gotta ask Annie. Annie doesn't like Nemo. I'll play Nemo. Annie doesn't like it.
Play Deborah by Beck.
She's okay. Moving. She's like, she's ignoring. She's just moving on.
That's what they want to hear.
Do you want to do Nemo, people? Do you like? If you say yes, how about this? I'm gonna play this song, and if Annie gives me the thumbs up, I will somehow get.
Jody Lipvac said, "Play the entire Michael Bolton catalog."
Oh man, that's a great idea.
That's next week, for sure.
Next week, we're gonna start
tune
doing
in next week, people.
Why not make themes? Sure. Yeah. I wanted to play this one, so Mindy told me to play something that comforts me, and I'm gonna play this one. Reviews.
Are you excited about having more than one show lined up for the foreseeable future?
Yeah, we've got like
you got
six.
You six got a tour gig. There.
And now we have a Michael Bolton gig, so we have seven. Here and now is Michael Bolton here now?
We all agree that you need a mustache with that shirt.
Fuck. You know what? Today I was shaving, and I literally I didn't really prepare for this. I actually went golfing with my neighbor instead, because I trust you guys to throw out good suggestions, and we're just going to make this happen, you know, together. And I went to shave, and I was planning on doing, like, the pencil, like, count of some dude from France guy, and I just spaced it, so I apologize. That being said... We have reason for celebration and much rejoicing here in the Humphreys McGee community. Joel and Dasha had a baby. So we have another Humphreys child in the family. And his name is Griffin. And I'm going to dedicate this song to him.
Did they tell you that it was a piece?
Oh. I don't know.
They might, I don't know. May,
I'm not on social media. I gave it up for Lent. So I don't know if he's posted. Yay! I hope it's okay. I mean, well, here we go. So this one's for you guys. That's not the point. The point is, I've been thinking about you. And this song is like the quintessential son-father gig. I'll try it. My child arrived just the other day. It came to the world in the usual way, but there were planes to catch and bills to pay. He learned to walk while I was away, and he was talking before I knew it. And as he grew, he said, I'm gonna be like you, Dad. You know I'm gonna be like you. And the cat's in the cradle and the silver spoon. Little boy blowing the man on the moon. When you're coming home, Dad, I don't know when, but we'll get together then. We're gonna have a good time. Day. He said, thanks for the ball, Dad, come on, let's play. Can you teach him to throw? I said, not today, I got a lot to do. He said, that's okay, and he walked away with a smile. Never did, and they said, I'm gonna be like him, yeah, you know I'm gonna be like him. And the cat's in the cradle with a silver spoon, little boy blue and a man on the moon. When you're coming home, Dad, I don't know when. Together then, we're gonna have a good time then. Well, he came from college just the other day. So much like a man, I just had to say, son, I'm proud of you. Can you sit for a while? Shook his head, and he said with a smile, what I'd really like, Dad, is to borrow the car keys. See you later, can I have them, please? And the cat's in the cradle and the silver spoon. Little boy blowing a man on the moon. When you're coming home, Dad, I don't know when, but we'll get together then. We're gonna have a good time then. My son's moved away. I called him up just the other day. Said, I'd like to see you if you don't mind. I said, I'd love to, Dad, if I could find the time. He said, my new job's a hassle and the kids have the flu. But it's sure nice talking to you, Dad. It's been sure nice talking to you. And as I hung up the phone, it occurred to me, he'd grown up just like me. My boy was just like me. And the cat's in the cradle and the silver spoon. Little boy blue and a man on the moon. When you're coming home, Dad, I don't know when, but we'll get together then. We're gonna have a good time then. Man, that song is powerful. God damn. Oh!
You pointed out that you gave up social media for Lent, but you are...
On social... This is YouTube.
Is YouTube not
social? It's a streaming service. I'm not looking at it.
That's true.
I'm not... I'm just...
That's true.
Man, trying to make me feel guilty. With all my Catholic guilt already swollen. Can we move on now? Have you made your point?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Venmo, how much would it cost to loosen a button?
$20. $20 a button.
Oh, boy. No. Come on.
What? $30. What do you want me to say? $40? $50. $70 for a button. Okay. Moving on. And it's going to charity. My kids. Okay, there's some friends that I've made in this quarantine that are watching tonight, and believe they're in Colorado. And, okay, so there's two of them, and they both made requests. And, okay, Rally, she made a request that I give a shout-out to Dre. Okay, and the song that she requested, unfortunately, I cannot do because Dre made a request, and he wanted me to dedicate a song to Rally. So I don't know if you guys are both there. I don't know if you're dating, if you're not dating. I don't know if there's some awkward tension, but it's just the two of you there. So I'm just going to sit here for a second. You guys just make out real quick. All right. Moving on. This song goes out to both of you. It's called Everything is Fine. I played it once before. I wrote it with my friend Nick Blasky from Cincinnati during quarantine. So that's why we call it Everything's Fine. Please don't think I'm cracking, I'm just stuck behind the wall. But thanks for asking, I appreciate the call. Everything is fine, so I tell myself. Maybe to remind somebody else. No, I won't forget you. At least I think I can. And I'm sorry if I upset you. It's good to know I can. Everything is fine, so I tell myself. But the numbers scream. Please don't load the wagon. You can wait until I leave. No, I'm not laughing. That's exactly what I need. That's exactly what I need. Everything is fine, so I tell myself. Maybe to remind somebody else. So if I'm quiet and the silence starts to get you, I'm not implying what you think you'll read. A little bias always tries to never let you open your eyes enough so you can see. But thanks for asking, I appreciate the call. You guys still with me here? Because I'm dragging ass and I need help. I need a little assistance. So I think it's time we step it up a notch. Oh, I wasn't ready for Annie, but I guess... She is. You guys ready for this? Come on up. Come on up, Buttercup. Oh, man. Look at this sweet little angel.
Cheers. Bye.
With your IPNA?
Yeah, my IPNA.
She's still holding true.
I know. Last year, remember? I mean, the first couple Wine Knots were a real doozy.
Yeah, they didn't happen because they're all blackout drunk.
Exactly.
So
doing the sober is over.
Dang. I believe in you. So, my brother Patrick, his lovely wife Sarah, and their baby Adrian. They sent us this request. Sarah sent it with a big yes.
Big yes.
Maybe you've heard of it through the Righteous Gemstones. We don't have HBO. So if one of you guys wants to share your HBO code. No? Okay, moving on. This one goes out to Patrick and Sarah. We're going to sing and we're going to dance.
Hallelujah!
But I said I'm gonna misbehaving.
Pies on the windowsill, swimming in the creek.
Catching crawdads and playing with a stick.
I wore lipstick.
I got caught shaving.
Just two little country kids outside misbehaving. Teacher said don't, but I said it anyway, misbehaving.
Preacher said no, if you do, you're gonna pay misbehaving.
Picking up and spitting and cussing out loud.
Running through the house with a pickle in my mouth.
Playing in the street.
Yeah, yeah. I mean,
I love it.
I know you do it well. You do it with grace. If there, yes, you do. Okay, man. So
should I do this like country?
Yeah. Shania Twain. No, you do.
I always wanted to be a country singer, but I'm from Chicago. It's like, can people from Chicago?
Yeah.
I feel like you gotta be from the South.
I think you gotta put your mind to it. I will give you a motivational speech if you need it. Right now?
No.
You.
No.
Okay, all right. How about you and I?
You and I.
Do this one.
Yep.
See what I did there?
I did.
Okay. This one goes out to all the Chicago people. Annie requested this one.
I did.
And I went, okay! But we're
and
gonna
like
do
10
it.
Times, I was like, we don't have to. Right. I still don't think he wants.
No, it's a good song. It's a good song. It's just that we're wearing matching.
That's cool.
Okay, okay. So. We get sometimes, it's like we never met. But you and I think we can take it, all the good with the bad, make something that no one else has.
Okay.
Time for one more. And oh, people, I missed you. I missed you so much. The last 2 weeks, Andy and I decided to get the fuck out. And we went to Hawaii for 2 weeks. And the only regret I have is that we brought our kids. Everything was beautiful, perfect. Weather was perfect.
They had fun.
They had a great time.
Damn, man. I drank a case and a half of non-alcoholic
beer. She did. She drank a case and a half of non-alcoholic beer. And we spent $90 on shave ice in the first, like, 2 days. I will say this because Roman's not watching, I hope. There's no way he is.
No.
He lost a tooth when we were there, and he was being kind of a dick. And he doesn't really brush his teeth very well. So the Tooth Fairy wrote him a note and said, well, first off, he wrote a letter to the Tooth Fairy. I would like WWE wrestling gear. I want Sasha Banks this. I want this. If you don't give wrestling gear, then I will take cash. That was his letter. The letter he got the next morning from the Tooth Fairy was, Dear Roman, your tooth is rotten and therefore worth nothing. I cannot give you anything for it. I do suggest you brush your teeth with a little more effort. He woke up and saw the letter and proceeded to rip it up into shreds. Hopefully the lesson was learned. So, do we have time for all this stuff? I don't know if we do. I was going to play Rocker 1. Do you guys like Rocker 1? Can we get a yes or no on it? Because it's kind of mellow. Kind of leaning towards it.
Nemo
or Rocker
Deborah.
One?
Deborah.
Nemo or Rocker One?
Dip, 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 dip.
First
Rocker One.
Rocker One? All right. Okay, we'll go there. Okay. Still not able to understand. I'm struggling here to deny it. If I knew this was all we had, I wouldn't have said goodbye then. It's only water, no spirit broken. All those things you've held on and left unspoken. Still the thoughts enough to make me choke.
man who couldn't sit still. He would think until his hands began to spill things. Every morning he woke up, never thought he'd done enough the night before. And it's hard to break the habits that we make, but don't you know that life could take it from you anyway? And if I could say it again, I'd make you remember when all these things we shared were unimpaired by anything.
You, buddy. Okay.
Somebody asked how much it would cost to get T-Bird and the broom back.
We can get T-Bird back. T-Bird, we'll get him back here. I don't know if tonight's going to happen. I got him very last minute. He's a man of mystery, and he needs time for prep. And put it on the docket. T-Bird, you're coming back. I have the broom. Mm-hmm. I have the chart. I have the cardboard.
Cardboard too.
I don't have the tube socks. All right, let's put that. T-Bird, you're coming back next time. We'll get him up here. Mike requested this song. I got to do it because he's asked for it 3 times. And I haven't done it for him. You guys got time for this? Okay.
Thank you.
$20 or $30? Because it's getting hot in here. I feel like Nelly. I'm going to take off all my clothes. We good?
Good. You, shout out to Trey. Jody.
Oh, yeah. Maybe. Trey Litvak.
First, why not?
Little man. Really? Little man. I cannot wait to tell you all the things.
No, you can't. You can't.
Some of the things. Little man. I look forward to meeting you, too. All right, so I got this request for a song that it's an Humphrey song that I just don't think it's going to work. But I'll try it because it's 4D, who lives in Madison, Wisconsin, from Kyle. Kyle referred to D as his lover. So hopefully it's not a shock to you, D. I'm going to try it real quick. I don't think it's going to work, so I'm going to try and pivot quickly. But when you open up your page, there's nothing there I could read or read. Or would I find myself on request I gotta say no to real quick. Robert, I think your wife will tell you, thank you for the donation, but the Bad Company song, I just can't do it. Carrie Rosenthal, I appreciate the compliment comparing me to Glenn Campbell. I can't do that song either. So I owe you, but I just can't do it right now. So we're running out of time, people. I know Annie's kind of tore up about it. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. But,
I am.
You are. All right. In all seriousness, my voice just cracked because it's so serious. You hear that? You hear that, Peter Brady? All right. I love you all, but right now I want to channel all of the positive energy I possibly can to my good friend Alex. And this one goes out to you. And Andrea, I'm thinking about you. Let's talk soon. Oh, man. If I could give you a digital hug, this is my version, but moving on. Hopefully this one will kind of scratch some itch.
You got my number, it's on you to make the call, and I won't bother you at all. But if you want, we'll get together. Once or twice, it would be nice to see you, and I'll believe you, even if a doubt enters my mind. We won't talk about our names here, and there is no find out, even if we've had a bit too much to drink, talk it out. I know the feeling of being lost and not being looked for. I made some plans with which life couldn't disagree more. I know direction and what it means to speed along. We've been provided with the means to make ourselves feel we belong. We won't talk about the things we can't forget. Deep inside, I'm not sure how to do that yet. I need to treat you like a cigarette and just put you out. Diamonds in a ring of gold. You say you want your story to remain untold, but all the promises we made, from the cradle to the grave, all I want. Just to look upon it, all the riches in the night. You say you'll give me eyes and a moon of blindness, a river in a time of dryness, a harbor in promises we made, from
Okay, I got time for one more. Tiffany sent me a request on Venmo, and I would have done it for free because the request was perfect. She said, I want you to tell a story about your favorite memory of Jeff Austin. So, I thought about it. Come take a walk.
How would you just one?
I know.
Favorite memory.
Well, this one's good. This one's good.
They're all good.
They're all good. I mean, there's some really good ones I can't tell you about, but this one, okay, so it's kind of fucked up because 10 days ago I was taking a walk by myself and I literally was having a conversation with Jeff, swear to God. Like, it was just, I just say hi to him. And Kevin Browning sent me a text 45 minutes later. And it was a clip of a video of this. And so this is 2006. And we're in New York City. And this is back when Jeff had really long hair and glasses. And Humphries was playing the Irving Plaza, Chicago. Anyway, it was a big deal for us, and he was in town, and we were partying after the first night. Somehow, at 3 in the morning, we decided that playing this next song was going to be the most fucking brilliant idea that New York City had ever seen. So, I told him, let's do it. The next day at soundcheck, I somehow convinced my band, who, God bless you guys for going along with this plan, because we had all the shit we had to learn. I was like, we have to fucking learn this song. So we learned it. And I get a text from Jeff. This is back when it was flip phones. And the text was 30 minutes before we go on stage. He's like, dude, I hope that you guys didn't learn the song because I just can't do it. I was up too late and my voice is shot and I can't sing, so I'm not coming. So I literally convinced my guys to learn the song. And it comes time at the end of the night to do it, and Jeff's not there. So I proceed to introduced the song to New York City, and I'm like, this song was supposed to be sung by my good friend Jeff Austin, who's the biggest pussy I've ever met in my life, because he can't show up and sing because he's a pussy. And as I'm saying Jeff Austin is a pussy, he walks in the fucking, I swear to God, the door's like open. He's in a coat that looks like he got it from Costco. Like, it's a very long winter overcoat, and I'm literally talking shit about him as he walks in. And he walked in from, what is it, Houston Canal, whatever, and he walks in and literally walks through the crowd up and grabs the lyrics and full-on jacket in no condition to perform on stage and sang this song. So this one goes out to Jeff, and good night, everybody. Hopefully I will do it some justice.